I was going to say, so let's talk, yeah, while we're on that, let's talk then about who's going to, if, who actually will get the most benefit out of this? I mean, one of the debates, as you guys are aware, and Luca, you've been on the forum in the industry there, you've got a lot of the guys that are the e-bike manufacturers or sellers who are concerned that somebody buying this bike, that they're not going to be able to see the same kind of performance they would with a dedicated e-bike, with a larger motor and a bigger battery pack and things like that. So who's going to benefit from this kind of technology? Are we talking younger riders? Or are we talking just standard bicycle riders? Old guys like me? where do you see that?
Actually, we are thinking that our system is a second generation of e-bikes. So the first generation of e-bikes is an e-bike in which you can have a big motor, you can have a big battery pack, and then the evolution of this system is having more efficient motors and larger battery packs, so you can ride for more kilometers, more miles with one charge, okay? So that's the first evolution of the bike. And we have Bosch system, we have a lot of different systems that are no more in the wheel, so they put the motor in the center of the bike, so right, that you can mount your own wheels and on all other stuff, and the bike is more balanced. And then they started to make the battery bigger, so starting from 160 watt hour, then 400 watt hour, then maybe 700 watt hour. So you can ride like for first 20, then you can ride for 80, then you can ride for 160 kilometers without charging the bike.
Okay.
And that's the first evolution of the bike. And then we think that we are in the second evolution of the e-bike, so where we have a product that's not making you doing zero fatigue like as a standard pedelec, is making you use your energy in a clever way, so you save the oxygen with respect to the normal bike. You are still making more fatigue than an e-bike, but you're making less than a normal bike, with the great advantage that you don't need to plug it in. Of course, since the market is not ready for this, because this is a new market, our bike, our system can be used also as a pedelec one, so can be used like with a smartphone, you can program that and you can say, no, I want to discharge the battery. Okay, so the bike lets you discharge the battery and then you can charge it at the end of the day. But that's not, I think, the best usage you can do of our system. From your just to reply to your question, people that want bike plus can be a guy that is riding every day in the city, and regardless the age or the training that he has, he wants something that it can help him to not sweat to go to work. Or some tech guys that want something that you can also reprogram, or for instance that you can also decide this morning I will do more fatigue or less fatigue, and this right, afternoon I will do more fatigue or less fatigue too,
right.
But at the end of the day, since I don't want to carry the bike where the charger is, or I don't want to charge the bike because I don't want to care about the bike, then I push my bike plus button and the bike plus will automatically balance for me the charge of the bike.
So I do not have to remember to recharge the battery.
I don't have to remember to recharge the battery. So a lot of people in Germany, when we went to Eurobike, told us this is the new generation of the e-bikes, because now e-bike customers are starting to care to worry about the recharging of the battery, because at the beginning it seems that the recharging of the battery is nothing, but when you do it all days,
right,
every day you take out your battery and you go, and it's like recharging the smartphone. What if you had a smartphone that use your energy, your body energy, and so you don't need to recharge it?
Right,
it's great, because you don't need, okay, maybe you have to do some fatigue with your arms to recharge the smartphone, but then you don't have to plug it in at night.
Right.
You don't have to remember to plug it in at night. And iPhones and smartphones discharge very, very quickly, and but they are always better and better and better and better. But they, in order to be better and better, they have to take the battery and make it bigger. And that's the first generation of bikes. In order to drive more and to drive better, you need a powerful motor and you need a bigger battery. We are saying that in order to drive a bike, not an e-bike, better, you need our system so you drive the bike smoother and better, and you don't need to charge the battery at the end of the day. That's our great advantage. And so we address to all people that is riding a bike, and all people that are riding an e-bike, and then they say, yes, but it's not a big problem not to do any fatigue. I can do some fatigue. But it's annoying to charge a battery every day.
Okay, right.
So that's the point. We are trying to go in the middle between to these two markets.
So where is the best place to take and ride your bike? If I lived in San Francisco and I had all those hills, would that be a bike that I would want, or would it work better on, let's say, for example, Manhattan?
So the thing is, according to the environment, the bike changes the behavior. But in San Francisco, you have these steep hills, okay? So you need a lot of power to go up to the steep hills. We can provide up to a good amount of power, but you will need to use your legs to go up.
Yeah.
Then when you go downhill, the bike will automatically recharge the battery. So the braking is doing with electric motor, and it recharges the battery. So in San Francisco, it could be very nice to use this bike because you have a hilly environment. Well, the thing is, when you go to San Francisco and you go by bike, usually you want to ride up top to the steepest hill of all, and you want not to do any fatigue usually, because you go up top, you have a great sightseeing of the city, but you don't want to do any fatigue.
Right.
And Bike Plus tells you, okay, I can make a lot of fatigue for you, but you still have to pedal. I'm not full. I don't push you up top.
Right.
I'm not full. You have to push.
Right.
If you cannot push like as you were on a flat, at least you cannot go up top. Of course, Bike Plus has limited power because of the laws here in Europe. So we have a 250 watts motor. We can, of course, as always, we can do like hills for an uphill ride for about 10-15 kilometers with no problems for the batteries. So San Francisco should be nice, but San Francisco is still a very, very steep hill.
Right.
See, so you need the power from your legs. You don't have a 1 kilowatt motor, or you don't have a 1.5 kilowatt motor that can bring you uphill, okay? But that's standard with all the pedelecs here in the
in Europe.
If you were in Manhattan,